is like a four-leaf clover, hard to find and lucky to have. A very warm and pleasant morning to all. Respected principal, vice principal, teachers, non-teaching staff, and my dear friends. I'm Neha Ennayar.
And I'm Ashita Singh.
Elated to welcome you all to today's enlightening assembly on the theme friendship.
Prayer purify our mind and soul. So, let's start this beautiful day with a beautiful knot and sing the prayer. I invite the class choir for the prayer.
Are the cornerstone of our success.
are vital to the smooth functioning and development of our school. We appreciate and thank all of you for being an integral part of our community. I would also like to warmly welcome our Vice Principal, Madam Elizabeth Reggie. Ma'am, your wisdom and knowledge are invaluable to us in our academic journey. Hearty welcome to you, ma'am. And last, but certainly not least, with great enthusiasm, I welcome all my fellow Nigerians to this gathering. Your friendship, energy and spirit make our school a wonderful place to learn and grow. Once again, I warmly welcome each and every one of you to this assembly. Let's celebrate the gift of friendship today and always. Thank you and have a wonderful day ahead.
Thank you, dear, for your words of welcome. My dear friends, a positive affirmation is a great way to train our mind to think positively. So I call Susan Phillips to gratify our day with a thought for the day.
Thought for the day. Friends are the one who help you to get up when you stumble, laugh when you fall, and keep going no matter what. By William Butler. A real friend is one who walks in when the rest of the world walks out, by Walter Winchell. These quotes emphasize about loyalty and presence in a friendship. A real friend remains by your side during the time of adversity when others leave. Together, both quotes emphasize this trust, support and a shared experience through the ups and downs of a life. Thank you.
Thank you, Susan, for your fair words. Updating ourselves with the news every day shows our awareness towards our nation and society. So, to notify us about the current happenings, here comes Heidi Owen, Therese, Anubhama, and Angel with the latest news. To one and all present here. I, Therese Anachako, myself, Anubhama Krishna, myself, Angel and Rose Unish.
And I, Harigovind PK.
Here before you, as reporters of Kristu Jyoti Vidya Niketan, to deliver with the latest updates.
International news. Australia has signed a deal to allow the exchange of nuclear material and secrets with the United States and Britain, a key step towards equipping its Navy with nuclear-powered submarines. China's President Xi Jinping pledged to strengthen ties with Fiji in a world beset with turmoil as he met the Pacific Islands Prime Minister Stephanie Rapuka in Fiji. The total number of 18,737 confirmed cases of mpox were reported in Africa since the beginning of the year, including 1,200 cases in one of the Bigelow. The armed wings of the Hamas and Islamic Jihad claimed responsibility for a bomb blast in Tel Aviv. The Israeli police and the Shin but intelligence agency described as a terrorist attack. Now I pass on my mic for national news.
National news. Wayanad landslides. Mundakkai, Churalmara and Attamala buried under debris in the massive landslide which occurred in the early hours of July 30th. Swollen river changed its course and flooded its neighboring localities. Kolkata doctor rape and murder case. Doctors protest in Port Blair, Andaman Nicobar Islands against the brutal rape and murder of the doctor in Kolkata. Healthcare hits as doctors join nationwide strike. Karnataka government to clear encroachments in Western Ghats. Karnataka Environment Minister Ishwar Khandre on Sunday announced the formation of a forest encroachment task force to clear illegal resorts, etc. in Western Ghats. I hand over the mic for the sports news.
Sports news. Paris Olympics 2024. Paris Olympics commenced this year on Friday 26 July with a unique opening ceremony. India won 6 medals. United States won the overall medal count at the Paris Olympics 2024. ICC Women's World Cup shifted to UAE. The International Cricket Council, ICC, on Tuesday shifted the venue of the upcoming Women's T20 World Cup from Bangladesh to UAE. The Indian Super League. The Indian Super League 2024-25 set to kick on September 13. Mohammedan FC will be the 13th team in this season. The 2024-25 ISL will be the 11th season of the Indian Super League. I pass my mic for the campus news.
Campus news. Mr. Aditya, the mayor of Bristol, UK, visited our school and interacted with the students. Kristu Jyoti Vidya Niketan is hosting the first Bristol Talent Hunt. The recordings of the event start by 22nd of this month and the last day for the submission of the recordings will be 30th of August 2024. Cultural Fest of the Year will be held on 28th of September and the venue for the categories 3, 4 and 5 will be Kristu Jyoti Vidya Niketan. Honor celebrations of our school will be conducted on 13th September 2024. To honor the teachers of our school, School Teachers Day will be held on 5th of September 2024. The literary competition of the year will be conducted on 31st of this month in Kuriakos Elias English Medium School, Manganam. To bring out the sportsmen in our Niketians, our school is conducting the Sports Day of the year on 6th of September. Half-yearly exams of grades 1 to 11 have been completed and the first term exams of this grade will start by the end of this month. Thank you and have a great day ahead. The news in the picture, Louisa May Alcott once said, good books, like good friends, are few and chosen. The more you select, the more enjoyable. Next, I invite Ashwati Binoy for the book review.
A very warm good morning to one and all present here. Myself, Ashwati Binoy, and today I am standing before you to say the review of the book of Mice and Men. Of Mice and Men is a 1937 novel written by American author John Steinbeck. It narrates the experience of George Milton and Lenny Small, two displaced migrant workers who move from place to place in California in search of new job opportunities during the Great Depression in the United States. George Milton, an intelligent but uneducated man, and Lenny Small, a bulky strong man but mentally disabled, are two great friends who wish to attain their dream of a farm of their own. They are migrant workers, but unlike other workers who were lonely, they were thick friends and were loyal to each other. After being hired at a farm, the pair is confronted by Curly, the boss's son, who suffers from Napoleon complex. Curly's wife, who was lonely, is attracted to Lenny, but Jenny, George prevents them from talking. Another man, Candy, who is old, promises George his money so that they all could buy a farm together. At this time, Lenny gets on the wrong foot with Curly and crushes his hand. He also kills Curly's wife and then ran away. When the other ranch hands find the corpse, they form into a lynch mob intent on killing him, then send for the police before beginning the search. George quickly realizes that their dream is at an end and hurries to find Lenny, hoping he will be at the meeting place they designated in case he got into trouble. George meets Lenny at the meeting spot and the two sit together and talks of their dream despite knowing it is something that will never happen. Upon hearing the lynch mob near them, George shoots Lenny, knowing it to be a more merciful death than at the hands of the mob. George is heartbroken and only his friend Slim, knowing of their deep friendship, understood what happened. Of Mice and Men is a timeless classic that explores friendship, hope and pursuit of the American dream during the Great Depression. So, dear friends, on Friendship Day, I advise you to be great friends and be loyal to each other. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashwati, for the glowing review. Now, I welcome Alma Jayesh on the stage to deliver the student's message.
A very warm and pleasant morning to one and all present here. Respected principal, vice principal, teachers, non-teaching staff, and my dear friends. I am Alma Jayesh and I would like to speak a few words on today's theme, friendship. Friendship is a relationship that is like a newborn baby. It is pure and becomes healthier when provided with nourishment. It is a divine relationship which is beyond the definition of blood relations. A true friend cares, shares, and is always honest. From sharing happy moments to sad ones, friends are the life support that helps one get through the most enjoyable and difficult circumstances. Lasting friendship is a blessing for everyone. We don't need to pretend to be someone else when we spend time with our friends. They give us total freedom to be who we are in reality. We should always be grateful to people who make us happy. A true friend is one of the most precious possessions in anyone's life. Friends are the ones who bring out the best in you. They will always be there for you to turn to your good and bad times. Friends are special as they never make you feel alone. They uplift you when you feel discouraged. They are the ones who also bring out the best in you. Emotionally, strong friendships offer us an unwavering support that can lift us up when we feel down. They can give us advice when we are facing difficulty. Be an ongoing inspiration for us and provide an environment to be ourselves. It is not common to find true friendship in life, but when you do, make sure you hold on to it tightly. True friendship teaches us how to love others who are not a family. Ultimately, our friends also become a part of our family. The value of our friendship lies in the mutual trust, emotional support, and the shared joy that comes from the enduring bonds and experiences forming the cornerstone of an emotional well-being. The most beautiful part of pouring our time and energy into friendship is that not only our friends enrich our lives, but we enrich theirs too. Friendships get us through the tough times in life, make things more fun and enjoyable, and all around makes our life better. I conclude my words wishing you a beautiful day ahead filled with laughter and a happy friendship day too. Thank you.
Thank you, Alma, for apprising us with your words. Now, it's time for a special program presented by our class which would glorify the theme of today's assembly. I invite all my dear friends to the stage.
the merchant of Venice. Scene 1, Venice. Enter Antonio and Bassanio. Antonio is a rich Venetian merchant who has invested all his money at the sea. He talks to his best friend, Bassanio, a noble gentleman.
Tell me, who is the lady to whom you have sold a secret pilgrimage? In Belmont, there is a lady richly left. Her name is Portia, nothing undervalued to Cato's daughter, Brutus' wife, Portia. From all over the world, rich suitors come to get a hand. Oh, Antonio, how I wish I had a place among them. It is not unknown to you how I had spent all my money lavishly. I know I owe you much, but if only you could give me more. I wish to have 3,000 ducats. Antonio, I promise you, even if I couldn't give back the first sum, I will surely return you this. You know, I have invested all my wealth at sea presently. Therefore, go, ask any man in Venice what my credit could bring him. It shall be exploited to the bottom.
Scene 2, Venice. Bassanio enters to Shylock. Shylock is a rich Jewish moneylender. Being a Jew, Antonio had insulted Shylock many times and he was waiting to take revenge upon Antonio.
3,000 ducats?
Yes, sir.
For 3 months?
Yes, sir. And Antonio shall be the credit.
Antonio shall be the credit. Though you have insulted me many times, I am ready to supply the money. But before that, you have to come with me to a notary and sign me a bond there. That if you fail to repay me 3,000 ducats in such a day and such a place, then I shall have all the rights to take an equal pound of flesh from the any part of body from the Antonio that pleases me.
I will not agree to such a bond.
Why, fear not, Bassanio. I will not forfeit the bond. I am expecting thrice the amount of money to be with me within the next few months.
So, Antonio agrees to sign such a deadly bond with Shylock. Along with his friend Graciano, set forth to Belmont. There, he had to face a challenging task. If he wanted to win Portia's hand, he should choose the right casket containing Portia's portrait among the gold, silver, and linen casket. Bassanio chose the right casket and they got married. At this happy moment, Bassanio receives a letter from Antonio that all his ventures had failed and presently he did not have enough money to discharge Shylock and the bond to him was forfeit. Antonio was imprisoned and he wished to see Bassanio at the time of his death.
Since Shylock remains adamant, I am ready to meet his rage with a quiet spirit.
Duke calls Shylock into the room.
Say, Chairo, can't you show some mercy on Antonio?
I am sworn by the Jewish Sabbath that I will have nothing but a pound of flesh from Antonio.
Why do you want to have a pound of flesh rather than 3,000 ducats?
I do not have a particular reason for that. Some men do not like cats and keeping pigs. Like that, I also have a strong dislike for Antonio, so I wish to have a pound of flesh from him. If you deny me, then it will be a great accusation against the Westminster justice system.
This is not an excuse to execute your cruelty. Do all men kill all the things they hate?
Hate is a good motivator. All men wish to see the things that they hate dead.
Do you think you can argue with the Jew? You can do all the hard things in the world, except to soften his heart, which is the hardest.
I will give you 6,000 instead of 3,000.
If every ducat in 6,000 ducats were in 6 parts, I would not have taken it. I would have my bone.
The Duke questioned Shylock how he wishes to have mercy when he offers none. Shylock asked why he need to fear when he had done nothing wrong.
With my powers, I can dismiss this court, unless Dr. Bellario has arrived.
Sir, a messenger has arrived from Bellario.
Meanwhile, Bassanio cheers Antonio.
I am the one who should die. The Jew shall have my flesh, blood, bones and everything before you lose one drop of blood for me.
I am like a sick sheep who deserve to die. The weakest brood falls earliest to the ground. You should leave Bassanio to ride my epitaph.
Shylock sharpens his knife on his soul.
Why are you sharpening your knife so keenly?
To cut a pound of flesh from the merchant there.
Not on thy soul, but on thy soul. No metal, not even the hangman's axe, has half the sharpness as thy malice. Can no prayers pierce thee?
No, none of the ones you are good at.
Duke says that Bellario offers a young lawyer to the court as he is sick. Duke asks for his entry. Portia enters the court as a learned young lawyer.
Are you acquainted with the case that offered?
Who is Shylock and Antonio?
Shylock and Antonio, both come forward.
Is your name Shylock?
Shylock is my name.
It is a strange case that you follow, but we cannot deny you it.
Portia asks Shylock to show some mercy, but he remains adamant to take a pound of flesh.
Can Antonio pay the debt?
I can pay twice what he is owed. In fact, I can even pay 10 times over with myself as the guarantee. If this is not okay, then surely a devil is working against us. Therefore, please use all your influence to change the law for this one time.
That cannot be. It would set a bad example.
Daniel comes to judgment. Yea, Daniel. Oh, wise judge, how do I honor thee?
Balthazar takes a look at Shylock's bond and says that he has all the right to take a pound of flesh. Antonio is tired and wished to have a speedy judgment.
Do you have scales to measure the pound of flesh?
Yes, I do.
Do you have surgeons to stop his wounds, or would he bleed to death?
It is not mentioned in the bond.
Meanwhile, Antonio and Bassanio hold hands and share tearful goodbyes.
Do not be sad upon my death. Lady Duck has been very kind to me since she is letting me die after all my wealth has been lost. Share my story of death with your new wife Portia and tell her how much I love you. I am not sad and do not regret losing a friend. I pay the debt with a full heart.
I am married to my wife, which is as dear as my life. But I would sacrifice them all to him to save you.
Portia is not thrilled to hear this. Portia gets back to the legal proceedings. She reads the bond again and again. She allows Shylock to cut a pound of flesh from Antonio's breast as he wished.
Yea, Nathaniel.
Halt! The lowly and all shall not get a pound of flesh. But in the process, if you spill one drop of Christian blood, you will face death and all your goods will be confiscated.
Is it like that?
You may see it your own. Since you crave justice so much, you should have it as you wish.
Then I will have the money 3 times over.
Here is the money.
Stop! The Jew shall have nothing but the bond. To take a bond Jew, they not spill any drop of blood. Also make sure that you cut an exact part of flesh, not more, not less.
A Daniel has come to rescue. A Daniel!
Then let the devil take him and leave him.
Stop, Shylock. The law has another hold on you. You directly and indirectly try to take the life of a Venetian citizen. So all your goods are confiscated and your life lies only at the mercy of the Duke.
By Antonio's timely intervention, Shylock was spared his life and was converted into a Christian. The two friends, Bassanio and Antonio, along with Graciano, returned to Belmont to find that Portia was the one who saved Antonio. So, dear friends, our assembly on Friendship Day reminds you to be like Bassanio and Antonio for their deep loyalty and mutual love towards each other. Thank you.
you, friends, for this astonishing performance. Teachers are the ones who motivate us to do better in every domain. They teach new things and help us discover our passion. I invite our class teacher, Mr. Sunil Thomas, for the class teacher's message.
Good morning to all. I think you might have already gone through the theme of the assembly. You are much familiar with the term friendship. You already know what is the importance of it in your life, but still I just want to say a few words regarding it. I got it from an article. This says that the person who has a good friend is going to benefit from the friend all these things. The first and foremost thing is that the most profound benefit of a friendship is the ability to instill a deep sense of belonging. It provides the person with a sense of belonging. It's very important. If your friend is providing that feeling of sense of belonging, that is more than enough to be a good friend. To having a friend who supports and believe you significantly boost your self-esteem. Your self-esteem is going to boost up if you have a good friend who knows you, who supports you in all your aspects. A good friend is always trying to withdraw us or you from your unhealthy behavior. Your friend will also say, always say, you are not doing the correct thing. But if he's not a true friend, he won't say that. You always want the good part of it. Saying that if I say something wrong to him, what he will think about me? Next day onwards, he won't talk to me. He's not interested in talking to me. Next day, if I say, you are doing the wrong thing. So always, a good friend always say, this is wrong. You're not supposed to do that. Some people find it too difficult in bringing up friends in a new environment. A good friend will always help the person to know how to make a good friend in an adverse condition or even a new environment. This is what is known as socialization. This all brings a learning for you. So making a good friend, easy for you to make friends, but to making a good friend is not an easy one. And a good friend will always help you in your life. Thank you so much and have a good day.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiring words. Next, I humbly invite our hardworking and beloved principal to the stage and share his valuable thoughts.
Hello, the radiance, rise and shine. How are you? Oh, my beloved, oh, first standard students, did you understand what are we doing here in the auditorium? Now, what magic? Matthew, what are we doing here? What is? We are conducting General Assembly. Who conducts it? Who is guiding? Our senior most students. Who are the senior most students? Plus one students. What is the theme of today's assembly? Friendship. Following. So let us put our hands together and give a great applause to our senior most students. Yeah, friendship. They did an assembly. It is masterful and skillful and with a high standard. So I have to congratulate our plus one students as well as their class teacher. Who is their class teacher? Yeah, our beloved students. sir. So I have to congratulate you. Friendship. Can you imagine a man's life without friends? That means he is leading a life that is the hell, real hell. If anybody doesn't have any friend, he or she is leading a life of hell. If anybody has more friends, they are leading a life of heavenly life. So you should not die towards hell. You should not die to see the heaven. You will experience hell and heaven here in our school. So everybody must have friends. Johan? Sleeping? Are you sleeping, Johan? Hey? Johan? Looking? Alright, my dog is. Very good. Very good. Okay. Okay. Very good. Very good. Enough. Yeah, day before yesterday, one of the Nigerians told me, Father, I don't have any friend here. I don't have any friend here. Then I asked him, I felt sorry about him, sorry for him, and I asked, why don't you have at least one? Then he was saying, he posted a selfie and he did not get any like for his selfie. So he counts friendship according to the number of likes and dislikes which he gets for selfies. I know our senior most students, high school students, they are having intimate friends. I find it during the lunch break time. Right. Alma was saying, friend is like a newborn baby, we have to feed them. And during the lunch break time, I find whoever brings biryani is eaten by his friends. Those who bring the biryani, he goes with an empty stomach. Right. His friends complete that. So in order to keep up our friendship, we have to feed. And the students have told us, good friends will always say, when you do something wrong, or when one of your friends speak Malayalam, very immediately a good friend must say, you have to speak English. If anybody doesn't study, then you have to immediately say, you are doing wrong. So that is what told by our students. And did you understand? Let me ask one of the senior students, what was the major theme of today's Merchant of Venice drama? What was it? Can any first standard student say? Second standard? Third standard? Any third standard student? First standard student? Oh, okay. So, what was the main theme of Merchant of Venice? My bonus, Matthew, friendship, very good. Yeah, the friendship between Antony and? Hey, senior students, Antony and Bassanio. Alright, Antonio and Bassanio against the very bloodthirsty greed of Shylock. Very good. My advice is, everybody must love friends. Everybody must love friends. One, two, one more than two. Okay? You have to include everybody in your companionship. Hey, my dear students, every day I find some students, they are moving lonely. They are only single-handed, they are moving in the provinces without any friends. I have one piece of advice. If your best friend is lonely, you have to keep them disturbing always. You should not allow them to be lonely. Okay, one more thing I have to do today. We have abolished slavery, we have abolished untouchability. So here in our school today, as a principal, I abolish Tico from this school. Okay? Whoever does the Tico, whoever hereafter, whoever does the Tico in this school will be given the GC. Okay? No more Tico. We are all good friends. congratulate our civil sir and his team members, that means plus one students. Okay, have a great day. Thank you.
Thank you, Father, for your valuable words. Now, under a few chairs, there are a few friendship cards. The lucky one can have it, and the one who got it can come to the stage.
They have kept some cards under your chair. The one who can get it, I think, Father, it is not there. Yeah, without making noise, one by one. Yeah, you are not supposed to upturn, just only look for that. Just look for it. Yeah, keep it down, boys. Keep it down. This is not the way you're supposed to behave. I told you to just look for it. Small children, class 1 and 2, I ask you to check for it, not to... Okay, now the one who got it, the one who got it, please. How many of you got it? Yeah, okay, please come forward. The one who got it, please come forward. I request the Father to just come onto the stage, or even he can just stay there. Yes, sir, down. Come, come. I think most of the 6 of them are there. Okay, you are lucky to get her.
Thank you, teachers.
I thank all the NOTT staff for their technical support and guidance. Thank you. And lastly, I thank all the Niketians without whom this assembly would be a failure. Thank you, friends, for leading us to your ears all this while. Once again, I thank each one of you. Thank you and have a nice day. Thank you, Femina, for your words of welcome. With that, we come to the end of today's assembly. Thank you, everyone, for your attention and participation. Have a fantastic day ahead, filled with happiness. I conclude my words with the famous words of Paulo Coelho. Friendship isn't a big thing, it's a million little things. Now, let's all rise up for the school anthem.
We are the best.